Good morning everyone. Today we'll be seeing about clinical chemistry. Okay, so clinical chemistry basic concepts we will be looking at and about automation and its advantages. Already in practical demo we have discussed about automation, what is autoanalyzer and its advantages and all. So in detail we will be looking at that today. And what are the basic concepts of clinical chemistry laboratory? This also we'll be looking at. Okay, so if you think of a lab, so what all the lab should contain, how the lab should be, so what are the responsibilities of the personnel or the persons, those who are working in a laboratory, and especially what is the role of clinical chemistry laboratory. So all this we'll be saying. So first coming to clinical laboratory, so what do you mean by clinical laboratory? See, lab means there are many different types of labs. There are research labs, clinical laboratory or diagnostic labs, okay, and chemical laboratory. Different labs are there. Okay, so clinical laboratory means it is a health profession where it provides laboratory services, okay, lab services and information that is required for diagnosis of a disease. Based on the lab reports, the disease can be diagnosed. So it has a role in education, research also, quality improvement and IT, information technology. So all these are the roles of this clinical laboratory. And the technicians or the technologists, they perform variety of tests, okay, that helps in diagnosis of a disease. So the patient walks into a hospital, physician checks him, examines him, and he might request for few tests that had to be done. So the patient will go to the laboratory, his sample is collected, processed, and the report is released. So collecting the sample, processing and all is done by technicians or technologists, okay, who work in a laboratory. And nearly 70% of medical decisions are made based on this laboratory result. So we have to be very keen, okay, we have to be very careful in releasing the report. So whatever report we are releasing should be reliable, it should be of quality report we have to give, okay. So if not, it will affect the diagnosis. And based on our diagnosis, based on our report only, the treatment also will be given, okay. And clinical laboratory personnel, so to give a reliable report, quality report, first the personnel, those who are working in a clinical laboratory, should understand the basic principles and procedure, okay, on how to operate the equipments or instruments in a lab, okay, and how he has to handle the samples. All this basic knowledge should be there for a personal laboratory personnel. And so if you think of a standardized clinical laboratory setup, so what all the lab will have first, okay, so there should be application of good laboratory practice. There are certain rules and guidelines under good clinical laboratory practice. So all those should be applied. So under that, few important points I would like to explain. So in detail I'm not going, just a basic concept of how the lab should be, so that we'll be looking at. So under that, first laboratory premises, okay, so laboratory premises should be, or the lab room should be adequate, okay. It should be spacious, it should be clean, uncluttered and free from obstruction, and there should be uniform and slip resistant floors and stairs if it is there. Then the walls and ceiling should be easily cleanable. Suppose if some sample is spilled, so the wall should be in such a manner that it is easily cleanable, easily it should be disinfected properly. So all this property the walls and ceiling should have. So this is about laboratory room, how it should be: spacious, clean, slip resistant floor, stairs and walls and ceiling should be easily cleanable. Next about heating, ventilation and lighting. Okay, so the laboratory temperature should be comfortable for working. Okay, for the personnel, mainly for the instrument. Okay, the fully auto analyzer and all, it should be kept under AC room. Okay, the temperature of that instrument requires working of AC. Okay, so all those temperatures should be comfortable and adequate ventilation should be there in the laboratory. Then services like sinks, wash basins, then water supply, electricity, power supply, then gas outlets should be placed in a proper places, and it should be working condition, examined and approved regularly. Okay, then adequate inspection should be done periodically. In case if anything is not working, immediately it has to be corrected. Okay, this is done periodic wise. Then fire prevention facility. So if there is any fire accident, the fire detection system, the alarm system should be in a working condition, in a proper place. Okay, it should be properly placed in a location, and all those detecting systems should be, again, it should be examined, inspection should be done periodically. Then electrical installations. For the working of analyzer, and if in case any instruments if we are using, they require, obviously electricity is required. So that has to be approved laboratory in lab. Okay, laboratory approval is required for that. Then storage facility. Not only placing of analyzers and all, so some places required for storing of samples, reagents, chemicals, etc. And the materials which we use for testing, all this has to be stored in proper places. And chemicals should be stored based on its nature. See, corrosive chemicals and all, it should not be placed in a very high levels. Okay, at the eye level, and some has to be kept in a dark region, and some chemicals has to be preserved in a cold storage it will require. So all these things, based on the nature of the chemicals, we have to store that. And along with storing, the labeling should be proper. Okay, the what all chemicals and what is the dilution or concentration of that solution, when it is prepared, is it concentrated, everything should be labeled properly along with date and time, and it has to be preserved or stored in a lab. Then sanitation and staff facilities. So under this, clean toilet should be there. Okay, and the lab should have both hot and cold water facilities for the staffs. And for washing purpose, the soap. So suppose if you handle the samples, again, once you finish the work, so cleaning of your hand is very essential after handling the sample. So soap obviously is required, and towels. So this comes under sanitation staff facility. Then coming to health and safety of staff, first aid box. Some accident, so you should be able to reach for the first aid box. Then potential hazard. So potential hazard of samples or the equipments or electrical hazards, so whatever it is, so the personnel working should have a knowledge, basic knowledge of this. Okay, and immunization program. Why immunization program? Because in lab, the working personnel will be coming in contact with various samples, either it is blood sample, urine sample, so that might be normal also, or it might be infected also. But all the samples that is coming to the lab, we have to treat it as infected only. We don't know what sample is infected, which sample is not infected. Many unknown patients will come without knowing what infection they have. So we have to be careful while handling the samples. So, and immunization programs are conducted regularly in a laboratory. Okay, the personnel working should maintain a file of his health. So where, what all immunization he has undergone, what it is required, what is planned after, everything is recorded in detail. Okay, this is about immunization program. Then about laboratory equipments that should be certified. Okay, and it should have SOP. What do you mean by SOP? It is standard operating procedure. Each analyzer, each instrument will have this. Each procedure will have this SOP, standard operating procedure. So this has to be well maintained and followed. And maintenance should be proper for all the analyzer. Not only handling, the maintenance also should be done in a proper way. And disinfection. If we touch any sample, how we disinfect or clean. So the similarly, the instrument also should be disinfected regularly. So all these are the basic components the lab should have. Okay, I hope you all understood till now. Now we'll move on to clinical biochemistry lab. So there are 3 to 4 main function of this clinical biochemistry lab. What it is? First is to advise the requesting doctor or GP, general practitioner, on the appropriate tests for particular medical condition. If the patient is diabetic, the doctor should know for diabetic patient what all investigation he should request. If a patient is suffering from kidney or renal disorder, the doctor should know what all he has to request for. Okay, it is also our biochemistry laboratory duty to inform or advise the doctors on requesting the tests. And on collection of the sample, it should be stored properly. It should be immediately analyzed. That is first. In case if it has to be stored, it should be stored in a proper manner, and the transportation also should be proper. All these are work of the clinical biochemistry lab. Then to provide quality analytical service for measurement of biological analytes. So what all analytes or investigations or tests which we are doing should be quality. Then the data interpretation we have to provide for the doctor, and advice on the service or on the outcomes of the test. This also we have to give. So this is the main function of clinical biochemistry lab. Now coming to automation. Okay, till now we saw what a lab is, what all components the lab should have, okay, and what is the main function of clinical biochemistry lab we have seen. Now coming to automation, this I already have told in practical demo. So what is automation? So maximum use of specimen processing equipments is made in automation, reducing the workload of persons or the technologists. According to International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, IUPAC, automation means replacement of human manipulative efforts, okay, with mechanical and instrumental devices. With humans, many manipulative things happen, okay, so errors also will be there. All those major errors can be avoided by using analyzers, automation, okay. And in simple words to tell what is automation, it is mechanization of various duties performed by lab personnel. So this is a simple definition for automation. Historical aspects, if you look at for the automation. So first automated system was introduced by L.T. Skeks. Okay, so he introduced the first automated system, and in 1957 itself, the Technicon, it is a company, so where it marketed single channel continuous flow analyzer. Okay, so this was the first auto analyzer which it came. So I told you auto analyzer means it works based on the automation. Automation, we have seen what it is. So large number of specimens without increase in staff. Okay, that is done by auto analyzer, and mainly it was introduced to take care of increased workload. So it is a self-regulatory process where a specimen is accurately pipetted by a probe mixed with the reagent, particular volume of reagent, and the reaction takes place, and the results are displayed in a digital form, and it can be printed also. So this is what is happening in auto analyzer. So coming to the classification or the types of autoanalyzer, main two types are there: continuous flow analyzer and discrete autoanalyzer. In continuous, we have single channel continuous flow analyzer and multiple channel continuous flow analyzer. In discrete, we have fully automated, semi-automated. Again, in fully automated, we have batch analyzer and random access analyzer. So what it is, we will see now. So first, coming to continuous flow analyzer. So in this, the flow is continuous, as the name itself is telling, and the separation is maintained by means of air bubbles, and mixing is done in a common pathway in the tubes, though that is joined by common pathway. It will have the probe to take the sample, to take the reagent, sampler to mix the reagent and sample and to hold the sample, proportioning pump to guide the flow, then dialyzer to get the protein free filtrate, heating bath if any heating or incubation is required that is made use of, colorimeter to take the reading, printer to print the results. And advantages is large number of specimen can be tested here, and the testing is very accurate and precise, and short duration also. But main disadvantage is it occupies a large space. So this is like our olden days computers, how big it was. It was slow also, and it occupied large space also. As the technology advanced, now the size has been decreased with more applications in it, and it is sophisticated. So similarly in auto analyzer also, the initial analyzers were very large, or the parts were not inbuilt, everything was separate, and the large space it required. Okay, now the auto analyzer which we are using is sophisticated, everything is inbuilt, okay, and with many applications. So secondly, we will see about multiple channel continuous flow analyzer. So here, so this multiple channel means it will perform from 6 to 12 tests can be done. So here also the Technicon company introduced two models. It is SMA 660 and SMA 1260. In 660, 6 tests can be done. 60 samples or specimen can be analyzed per hour. In SMA 1260, 12 tests can be done. 60 specimens or samples per hour. Okay, but whatever sample you keep, all 6 tests, all 12 tests will be done. But all these tests might not be required, or the physician who is treating the patient might not be interested in all these parameters. Okay, that is the main disadvantage here. So this is one of the Technicon model analyzer. You can see how it is. Then coming to discrete auto analyzer, so this is, it operates multiple programs, okay, so multiple operations in a smoothly functioning system, that is called discrete auto analyzer. Basic features already we have discussed. So reagent and specimens are pipetted into cuvette, mixed, the end product is recorded photometrically, and all types of reactions, endpoint, 2-point assay, kinetics, everything can be done. More than 100 tests can be done, and it is economical. How it is economical? The analyzer will be costly, but the test cost per test will be less. Okay, it is economical because the reagent volume which we are using is very minimal. It is in microliters, and the patient wise report can be stored. Whatever patient report we want, we can just enter the ID number or the patient name, we will get the report immediately. And quality control, in detail about quality control, we will be looking at the later on classes. And results are stored, as I told. Apart from routine chemistry, special chemistry also can be done. What is routine chemistry? Glucose, urea, creatinine, lipid profile, liver function test, all these are routine chemistry investigations. Special chemistry is our is your hormone analysis, like thyroid function test, vitamin D, B12, fertility profile. All this comes under special chemistry. And main thing is, main property or feature is, it is user friendly. So this is one model of fully auto analyzer. You can see it is from Erba company. Here you can see this is for storing of reagents. Many reagents you can see, not only for one tests, all the tests you can arrange it here. And here we can keep the sample. These blue color ones are the probes. So one probe is to take the sample, one probe is to take the reagent. And here there is cuvettes. Okay, so the mixing is done by one probe. Okay, and if incubation is required, that is also done here. So everything is inbuilt here. Okay, reagent, sample, and mixing is done here. And the system is here, which displays the result, and it is stored also, and print also can be taken. So this is fully auto analyzer. And coming to semi auto analyzer, so in semi, initial steps of the tests is done by a laboratory personnel or the technician. Initially what he has to do, pipetting of the sample, reagents, mixing, incubating, all this work is done by technician. By the analyzer, after mixing, you have to keep it in the analyzer, then it will give out the reading. Taking the sample, giving out the reading, graph, printing. This is done by semi-auto analyzer. So this is semi-auto analyzer. This is also from Erba company. So here you can see the display. So the results are displayed digitally. These are the numbers. So each number will be programmed for particular test. And this is a switch to on and off. Here you can see a white small pipe here. So this is inlet. Here you keep the sample mixed with reagent. This will aspirate inside. So inside all the reaction will take place, and finally it will give the report here. Then this semi-auto also is economical. Here also very minimal quantity of reagents we are using. This is also user-friendly, and SOPs will be stored. Standard operating procedures will be stored here also, and the graph will be plotted by the instrument itself, analyzer itself. It can be printed, and standard deviation, all this in detail. Levy Jennings chart in quality control class, I'll be dealing with that. And immunoassay, coagulation profile, drug assay, all this can also be done in semi-auto analyzer. Okay, semi-auto analyzer also gives accurate results, but the working will be more. Okay, if the analyzer itself is doing everything, workload for the technician will be less, but here in semi it will be more. And it operates with battery backup system also. Here you can see types of semi-auto analyzer. So one semi-auto analyzer which will have a incubator at 37 degree centigrade, it will have 12 cuvette position. Examples are Mini Lab, Point A 180 plus, all these are the company names or the model names. And semi with metal thermocuvette is there, automatic aspiration it does. Examples for this is Metro Lab 1600 plus, Biotron, BTR 810, all these are the names. And with the triple cuvette system, triple cuvette means it will have a flow cell, manual square, and round tube for coagulation. For each cuvette type is used different types. Okay, so that is example Erba Chem Plus 5 plus, Erba Chem Pro, etc. So fully auto analyzer, automatic dispensing of everything. Okay, like reagent, sample, mixing, everything is done. So sampler is there to accommodate samples. Along with samples, you can keep standard, calibrator, and QC also. Standard means to check whether an instrument is working properly. If it is not, we have to calibrate it using a calibrator. In detail, I'll tell in QC class. So sample volume here also, it is 3 microliter to 30 microliter. And it will have, main feature of this is, it will have sensors. Sensors both for sample and reagent. Sample quantity, there will be a level above which the instrument will not accept. So there will be a beep sound, then we have to go and check out what is the problem there. If the sample quantity is less, if the reagent quantity is less, we have to refill it. Okay, we have to put extra and keep it. Then reusable reaction cells. Once the cuvettes are being used, it is washed, disinfected and cleaned properly, and then again it is used. Cuvette rinsing station is there to rinse the cuvettes. So if the cuvette is not rinsed properly, if the next test when it is being used, it might interfere with the test report of the other patient. So here you can see. So these are the samples. Here we can keep standard calibrator, everything. Okay. Batch analyzer, this has become outdated. One particular test at a time can be done here, and batch wise the samples has to be divided. All the samples which has to be analyzed for glucose is kept separately in a batch, that is analyzed first, then take out, keep for the next batch. So this is tedious also, and this is not being used also now. Okay, it is not patient oriented mainly. And random access analyzer. What is random access analyzer? So completion of all the tests of one sample before proceeding to the next. Okay, that is called random access mode. Then sample orientation mode is there. So greater number of samples in shorter time it can be done. And sequential type also is there, one type at a time. So all these features are there in fully auto analyzer. And it will have a cuvette disk with temperature control for the incubation. Reagent table for the storing of reagents. This also will have the lever sensors, sample rack system, then barcode identification. In the sophisticated labs and all, the patient sample is identified with the barcode. Okay. Then continuous loading of samples. You need not wait for one sample to be completed. You can load continuously. So once the first loaded sample test is completed, the instrument will take the next sample. So you can keep continuously. Auto dilution facility is there, where we can, if the report is not convincing, if it is very low or it is very high, we have to recheck it with dilution. So the instrument will have this auto dilution that will only dilute the sample and perform the test. Okay. Whereas in semi-auto analyzer, the technician has to dilute the sample and perform. Here it is auto-dilution. Then daily and monthly QC chart is prepared. Then ISC, ion selective electrode. So for the analyzing of electrolytes, you need not use separate analyzer to estimate or analyze sample for electrolytes. In this instrument itself we can do. So in our lab, in clinical biochemistry lab, we have separate electrolyte analyzer also, and one fully automated clinical chemistry analyzer is there, one hormone analyzer is there. So when you all come back, you can just go have a look on that. And semi-auto analyzer also is there. So this is one of the semi-auto analyzer. You can see how sophisticated it is. So this is by the company Beckman Coulter. So this is very costly, and the but it is sophisticated. Here you can see inside is the place to keep sample, reagents, everything. From here the sample is loaded, it is taken inside also, where the mixing, reagent aspirations and all is done. So here batch wise you can load the sample. So once it will take one batch inside, after that is done, the next batch is taken. Here the results are displayed. The benefits or advantages of automation: large number of samples, okay, and workload can be reduced. Large number of samples in a short time we can do, and various tests with various methods can be done. Then ELISA, chemiluminescence, immunoturbidity meter, everything can be done here. And hormone assay, drug analysis, drug assay, tumor markers, everything can be done here. And the main feature of this automation is the reports is reliable, it will have quality, it is accurate, precise, and sensitive and specific. Okay. The tests are cost effective. I told you reagent what we are using is very less quantity we are using. That is one of the main feature. And much larger workload can be managed without increase in the staff members. Then internal quality control program, every day it is done. External quality control, monthly once we are doing it. So all these programs, quality management programs are done effectively and efficiently by these auto analyzers. Okay. And staff working, they do not come in direct contact with the sample. Everything the instrument is handling. So working is very safe in this instrument. Okay, this completes clinical chemistry. In clinical chemistry, basic concepts and about automation, auto analyzer and its advantages. So next class we will be looking at quality control, both internal and external quality control. In detail we will be looking at. Okay, thank you.